anybody from Wyoming will tell you the wind here is almost always blowing.
But today, a familiar landmark along the Colorado-Wyoming border is still. The Ponnequin Wind Farm has been shut down and decommissioned by its operator, Xcel Energy.
It was no longer in the best interest of our customers to keep operating it. Really, they're two separate issues. The Ponnequin Wind Farm is nearly 20 years old. It is relatively small in size. It did not make sense to keep investing in the operations of that facility.
The average lifespan of a wind turbine is about 20 to 25 years. But with maintenance and equipment and upgrades, a turbine could last up to 40 years. These 44 turbines have been around for 18 years and had a capacity to generate 750 kilowatts of electricity each. But technology has changed. The average wind turbine built today generates twice that or more. Jonathan Naughton directs the Wind Energy Research Center at the University of Wyoming. He says the decision to decommission comes down to economics.
A 15-year-old wind farm is on the verge of where that business decision could be made to shut it down. Now, hopefully in many cases, they would choose to repower, put in new turbines in place if the wind farm is amenable to that.
But these turbines won't be replaced because in order for large operators like Xcel to invest, wind farms need to be bigger in order to be profitable. So the Ponnequin site will come down. And bison rancher Ron Thiel wants to make sure it's cleaned up the right way.
All the disruption of grass, which means roads, concrete, chain link fences, towers, they need to be gone so that we're back to square one, which is how they received the property.
Thiel owns and leases some of the property where Ponnequin was built in Wyoming and Colorado. Xcel says it's committed to eliminating any trace of the wind farm once it comes down. But when a wind farm needs to be cleaned up, it's tricky because there's no one set of rules. Instead, it's a combination of federal guidelines, sometimes state regulations, sometimes private agreements. It all raises questions about the long-term environmental impacts of these farms. Nationwide, there are around 49,000 wind turbines and at least 2,700 that have been decommissioned since America's first wind energy boom in the 1970s. Most of these retired turbines are in Southern California. The Tehachapi Wind Farm sits on the edge of the Mojave Desert. It was built during that initial wind energy boom decades ago. But many of the older turbines are no longer working, like skeletons standing on the desert hillside, slowly decaying. Back then, there was very little regulation.
When they were built in the mid to late 70s, they didn't have a lot of permitting issues about who was going to take them down or who was going to recover the sites after, you know, after they were done producing power. When the bottom fell out of the market, most of the companies that produced the wind turbines went bankrupt.
The broken down past serves as a reminder of the need for an adequate cleanup plan today.
Even though the Ponnequin site spans two states, the turbines themselves are in Colorado and subject to a patchwork of state and local regulations. But here in Wyoming, regulators say they saw the future coming and put rules on the books a full year before the federal guidelines came out.
In Wyoming, wind energy producers are required to put up bonds to cover the cost of taking down turbines and returning the land to the way it was. Outside of Rawlins, Wyoming, construction is scheduled to begin late this year on the largest planned wind farm in North America. The Chokecherry and Sierra Madre Wind Project will populate these remote bluffs with giant next-generation wind turbines, generating enough electricity for around 3 million homes. Like Ponnequin, this massive wind farm will span government and private land. Here, the Bureau of Land Management has taken the lead.
The surface is our jurisdiction. And that means all elements of the habitat, the soils, the vegetation. So when it comes to what we require to be put back, I think is pretty comprehensive.
The federal BLM is also working side by side with the Wyoming Department of Environmental Quality to oversee the project. Now, bonding is required for the full amount of decommissioning and reclamation.
So if somebody did walk away, we do have security in place to close that facility out. All that is spelled out up front before the project even begins construction.
The State of Wyoming BLM partnership may set a new blueprint on how wind farms are managed and eventually decommissioned. But to date, there are no binding federal regulations in place.
I think, yes, we need to have a consortium that is willing to discuss these things and understand they all come with different perspectives, but in a way that it's economic to develop wind plants moving forward.
As for the Ponnequin Wind Farm, Xcel's plan is to blow up the towers this fall and then disassemble the blades. Some of the structure will be recycled as scrap, and the rest will end up in a landfill.
You have to realize with renewable energy, it's not free from impacts.
For Inside Energy, I'm Leigh Paterson.